first question, Mr. Mike Frey is playing you in the FX series coming up, the Sterling Affairs. What are your thoughts about that, being that he is a fellow Bruin as well?
For one, I'm ecstatic. Mike Frey, that's my brother. We actually came into UCLA together.
Okay.
So for Mike to be playing me, that couldn't be any more greater of an honor. For one, I wonder, do I have speaking roles? I get to do stuff, but I think just hearing that Mike is doing it, that's like super, super cool. But I mean, one of the best guys, man. We went to the national championship together, came, lived in the dorms together, struggled together. So that's my guy, man. I'm ecstatic that getting that opportunity there for Mike to do that. And like I said, if I get some speaking roles or something, that's even cooler.
I can figure out how that's all working. I know it's just like in the works now. I think he was supposed to come out this year, but because of, you know, at the beginning and things of that nature, I think they pushed it back. But where were you when you saw the 60, 20, and 10 the other night?
I didn't see it. We were playing in Boston. We were in Boston, I believe. So I heard about it. I saw the tweets. I saw things go off. And it didn't surprise me. I mean, he gave us 50 kind of a few games ago. So Luka just has, he's one of those talents where he's going to break every record imaginable. He's the European LeBron, you know, just plain and simple. And he's got the Larry Bird skill set, you know, at such an early age. And in today's NBA, where you'd allow a 6'8 guy to be your primary ball handler rather than your power forward, which he, what he may have been in the past.
I know 2005 Kobe is something that I, you know, that came to mind, the way the scoring output is. I mean, I know it's early, but is it any feeling towards that? Because I know he scored 62 on the Mavs that year, outscored him in three quarters. Luka's, you know, on a scoring tear right now. He's got a couple 50s. I think Kobe had 4 50s in a row or something like that. Does that even come close to that in your mind?
Oh, yeah. Luka can break those. The only question with Luka is his conditioning of, like, hey, like, do you want to score 50? Because where he works from, you can't really double team him, and there's shooters spaced around him on the entire floor. So you may get the ball out of his hands, but you're going to give up three-pointers all night long. And then, you know, he doesn't cross it. So unless you're going to trap Luka at half court just to get the ball, you're going to go box and one or something like that, you're not going to be able to shut him down. So, you know, he could go on one of those tears and then shoot. He's shooting a step-back three-pointer from, you know, a couple steps behind the line. But when he gets hot, he's different. He hits contested shots, and you really can't help.
You think he could score 81 or even anything close to 100?
Maybe not 100. I think he'd score 80. You get an overtime game. Yeah, Luka could score 80. Yeah, I definitely believe that.
And then obviously Dirk got his statue on Christmas. Your former teammate out there, is just thoughts on that. I know you haven't seen it yet, but yeah, just thoughts about him just, you know, getting that finally.
Couldn't be more well-deserved to a better individual for getting to basketball and what he's done for this city. I love that Mark does it right for the former players, takes care of the guys, and what, like I said, what Dirk has done here in Dallas, that's beyond well-deserved. So I'm ecstatic for Dirk. I'm happy for him, man, and he's one of my funnest teammates, and the impact he's had on my career has been amazing.
Two more questions for you. Tatum and Brown, last year they, you know, everybody was saying we should trade them. Now they're looking like they're saying Scottie and Michael. Just thoughts about that, being a former Celtic, and things, you know, just.
We just saw them the other night. They look different, man. When I say different, like, you had those guys with that championship look in their eyes or the MVP look. Jason Tatum walked into 38 points. If he wanted to turn it on, he could have dropped 50. He walked into 38 points. You can't really guard those guys. Now they're spaced around shooters. They kind of have their thing. I thought, and honestly, in last year's finals, I thought they were a better team, top to bottom. They just didn't have the experience, and that's what, you know, really, like, ran through. But right now, they're at that stage in their careers where it's their time.
I think that Tatum's been looking different ever. I mean, I don't know how many pro times he went to, but what I saw on the stream in Seattle this past summer with LeBron and those guys, I think that helped elevate his game, trying to be out there with those guys. I mean, just
he knows he's one of those guys now. He knows, and that confidence is everything. And he can get his three off over anybody. He's got that type of drive. And then if he he's getting to that unguardable point, you know. I think the next step in his game is probably playing the pick and roll, attacking multiple defenders, defenses in various ways. But he's a unique basketball player, man. It's his time. And, you know, Jaylen Brown's on the other side. Like, oh, he's going to guard him. Who's going to guard me? You know, so, man, they are a tough matchup right now.
And then Joker. Do you think he could get a third one? He should.
Statistically, he should. Unless, you know, one of those other candidates has the best record in the league and it's unanimous. Other than that, he should. He's so efficient. The ball goes through his hands. He's a point center.
Yeah.
Right? Like, he's a point center. So, his efficiency, he's playing on another level, man. And then he makes the right play night in and night out. And the thing for him, he can do that every night.
Right.
He plays at his own pace. He's chill. He can make those plays every single night. And they're just different with him on the floor. But the command he has over the game right now, it's extremely unique.
And then James Harden, there's rumors that he might come back. He went on the record and said he's happy in Philly, but I mean, the questions are always going to be asked with his ties to Houston. Just thoughts about, you think he's going to come back potentially, or do you think that they would even want him back with what they're trying to build right now?
Honestly, I have no idea. I think you got to be ecstatic and love James for what he did, his time in Houston. I think that what he's done in Houston will never be forgotten. It's one of the most amazing seasons you've ever had in Houston and in the NBA, man. The run that he had went on, and I'm kind of sitting back and waiting to see like everybody else.
And then final question: Kimba just got signed a couple weeks ago. I think you guys played together. I'm not 100% sure.
I didn't.
But just thoughts about him being back in the league.
I'm so happy for him, man. He's one of the good guys in the league. Like, I mean, amazing people behind the scenes. You just hope that knee is okay, hope he's up to par. But as far as his game, you've seen it a couple games already here in Dallas. He can skate and he can score the best of them. He is a tough cover, man. So hopefully his body holds up. But he's different, man. Kimba, one of my favorite players, definitely. But an amazing dude behind the scenes. I'm ecstatic for his opportunities. And, you know, he just stay healthy and he's going to have more of them.